everyone, and welcome to the Tequila Caps podcast. I'm Adam, and we're here with
Fran.
And yeah, so welcome back for episode two. We didn't think we'd be doing this again, but
well,
here we are.
Yeah, we're sitting in these chairs, so I guess we're here.
Yeah, I guess we are. So
yeah, so Hugh, do you want to kick us off with? Don't kick us off because we just started. But do you want to set us off with the first topic of this week?
Well, I mean, the first topic of the week is us. I mean, the audience doesn't really know us, so I feel like we should let them get to know us. So, I mean, introduce ourselves properly.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'll go first then. So my name is Adam, as most of you guys know. I am a student here in DCU. We're all studying multimedia, so I'll like clarify that for everyone anyway. When I'm not in college, I kind of do, I feel like it's a bit of a meme at this stage. Like, yeah. I do custom shoes. So, you know, I hand paint sneakers and stuff like that. Sorry, shoes, because my producer who's waving at me right now doesn't actually like the term sneakers. Aside from that, you know yourself, I just do a bit of fitness here and there. I drive, life skill.
He's got all the old man stuff.
I've got all the old man stuff. I have glasses as well, so that yeah, completes the ensemble. But yeah, I'm quite a boring dude. I have my own YouTube channel. You can follow it at ANG. Just a mixture of dance videos, custom videos, tutorials, etc. And my Instagram is Adam or Gavin. So that's it, really. Oh, and of course, Plain Canvas Customs is the shoe page. So Hugh, on to you.
All right. So that was boring.
Thank you.
So I'm Hugh. I'm also studying multimedia in DCU. Shocking, I know, but that was a bad voice card.
Crazy.
It's crazy. Yeah. So I'm a YouTuber as well. I make videos at Hugh Barret, and I also just kind of generally chill out and just kind of hang out. That's usually what I'm doing. I'm just
chilling out.
It's all hanging out. Yeah, no, I'm not too interesting, but I'm just here. I'm just chilling, you know.
Just you.
I'm the, you know, we got Adam. He's the old man of the podcast. I'm like the stoner friend of the podcast, really. So
we have to give Fran a title. So speaking of which,
So my name is Fran. I am doing multimedia as well. No shocker there.
This is like a repetition.
I know.
Something's going on here.
What is my personality trait?
Digging through the archives.
I'm there thinking, well, I love music. Don't play, except I play a bit of piano here and there, but not special. Ooh. And yeah, I love being on Twitter.
That's a downside.
I know, it is. So that just tells you a lot about me there already. I'm not like stand Twitter that's under the comments saying like,
yeah,
not that.
You know, I feel the skill would be I'm bringing the old energy, you're bringing the stoner energy, and you're bringing the female energy.
I am bringing the female energy.
Yeah, we all got something.
And the modern side as well. Probably I'm the youngest here, actually.
Well, you're like 44.
I'm nearly, you know, at
you're
death.
You're a pensioner.
I'm a pensioner at the age of 24.
I'm a ripe old 19-year-old boy. I'm a little baby. And
I'm an 18-year-old girl.
Hey, so you are the youngest.
I am the youngest. Yeah.
Congratulations.
Well, you're representing all the ladies out there on this podcast.
And the youth as well. Don't forget the youth.
The ladies and youth combo. So now that we have kind of
gotten that out of the way,
we got that out of the way. Yeah. So now that we've introduced ourselves, I think Hugh, you have quite a story to tell us about a certain bar that you attend.
Well, right.
This might clarify things about Hugh as well.
Okay. So first of all, you should look at the date. It's the 5th of it's 5th of November. So Halloween has just passed last week.
Absolutely.
That was just on Sunday. So, I mean, you guys do anything special for Halloween? Anything interesting?
I did.
Oh.
What did you do?
I went out. I went clubbing, actually.
Oh.
Yeah,
very fancy.
From the nightclubs this time, I went, actually. And it was an experience. It was something like felt like 50,000 people all over you, sweaty bodies and everything. It was great.
Yeah, but I'm trying not to get too excited.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, great crash.
There was sweat everywhere.
Yeah, that was it. That's like the one highlight of it.
That's fair.
Now, mine wasn't as interesting, but I think I got confused because Halloween was Sunday and I was like, oh, sure, everything's happening on Sunday. But everything was happening on Saturday, so me and my friends didn't really predict that. So on Sunday, I'm pretty sure I dressed up as a Peaky Blinder, you know, keeping my age, got to keep the old aesthetic going. And me and my friend just drove around and... like I went out like with him at like 11:30 and I didn't get home till like 4 a.m. just driving. Wow. So it was fun, but you know, the old man was tired.
Yeah, that's fair. I mean, you were actually part of the Peaky Blinders, right?
Like I was.
I saw him. He was an extra.
I'm in that one scene. of every scene. Yeah. Just my hand.
Just him, just in the background.
My finger pops out behind the wall. He's like, that's my finger.
But yeah, I had an interesting enough experience. I had gone out the 2 days beforehand, so the Friday and the Saturday, and then it came to the Sunday, and I was working that day. I worked an opening shift in the shop I work in. So I went to work at 7. I got up at 4. I was very tired. I had been offered to go out, and I was like, no, not really. And then about 5:40, my friend Ethan texts me, and he goes, hey, do you want to go to a gay bar? And I was thinking...
Like you do.
I was thinking...
Just a casual thing,
just
know.
A casual thing, you know.
Yeah, sure, why not?
I love the time and everything at 5:40. You yeah. Look down, you remember this, very vivid.
I do. Now, it's the George in Dublin, which I've been to a couple times before.
Don't think anyone knows the George, no? No, it's quite a niche place.
It's quite a niche, small place. You might not have heard of it. Biggest gay bar in Dublin, but it's a lovely place. But I've only ever been to it like as a bar, not as a club, because it's a club. They were just doing like drinks while COVID was happening and all that. So me and my friend Ethan get sent tickets by our other friend, who's already there, and we thank you for the ambient water drinking.
We can hear a friend taking a sip.
Yeah, you know, I was like, I didn't want to make a big sound of it. That's so okay. Just go ahead.
Maybe we should just take our lids off and just like just have like, the lid off ready to
I'm
go
just
or something.
Keep it away from me. But so we head down. Everyone else is already there. Me and my friend Ethan head down. And we're on the bus from Kildare to Dublin, and Ethan turns to me and he goes, oh shit, I forgot my COVID cert and I forgot my passport. And so I'm dog, like, that's, you've already fucked us up here. Like, we're done for, we're not getting in. We're just going to have to go to like a straight bar or something.
Oh, a straight bar or something.
Yeah, he goes, no, it's fine. Look, I'll get my parents to send me my COVID cert and my passport. And I'm like, okay, the COVID cert will be fine, like they'll accept it on your phone, but they won't take your passport. So we get in the line to the George.
They don't take your passport?
They won't take a picture of the passport.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was a picture. That's what I thought, because they're kind of strict in the George. We get in the line, we line up, and I, the whole time I'm going, we're not fucking getting in. We're not getting in. It's, you know, may as well go home at this point.
Yeah.
We get to the, we get our tickets scanned, and the guy goes, lads, wear the costumes. It's Halloween. And I go, oh, I'm Shaggy from Scooby-Doo. I had like...
Was it the same thing?
Okay. I had like under my hoodie. And he was like, he looked me up and down. And he just goes, you don't need a costume, lad. And
my night's
going great. My friend and I probably aren't getting in. I've been roasted. We get to the door. We get our COVID cert scanned. He checks my ID. He's like, okay, go ahead. He checks Ethan's ID. And then he's like, oh, yeah, go ahead. And so we're like... oh, fuck, we got in. We were just like, oh, shit, what do we do now? So we go in and we go find our friends. And I walk up to one of my friends who's at the bar and I go, hey, can you get me a drink? Because it's like a huge line at the bar. And he's like, yeah, sure. So I'm standing behind him at the bar waiting for him to get my drink. And this one guy standing next to him turns around, kind of looks at me, looks back, does a double take, looks me up and down, and just goes, hey. I was like,
if you guys could see the face that he pulled while he did
it. It was like, already I'm getting the fuck me eyes. So I'm like, okay, this is the fuck me eyes. So I'm like,
apologize, listeners.
So I'm like, okay, cool. It is a gay bar after all. He was a lovely chap. His name was Liam. He danced on me a little bit. He was definitely giving me the fuck me eyes. But then he disappeared after 10 minutes. So I'm like, okay. That was not the only guy of the night, though. Another one, his name was Ash. He was talking to my friend Ethan, and he was talking, I heard Ethan say like, oh, you're French. And so I turn around to the guy and I start talking to him in French. I'm like, tu parles français, which means, do you speak French? He goes, un peu, which means a small bit. And then,
okay, we're learning on this podcast as well.
I speak a bit of French as well.
Oh, congratulations.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Je parle un petit peu French.
And so then, you know, that guy also gave me the fuck me eyes. I was like, okay, cool.
The usual stuff. So you're attracting the dancers and French people.
Yeah, the dancers and the French people. Two other interesting things that happened. One, my friend Andrew had a pint glass, and he was dancing with it, and he dropped it, and it smashed right on the ground. And we were like, oh, shit. So, like, Andrew goes over to, like, get another drink at the bar, comes back with it, dances, drops it right on top of the other one.
Oh God!
So there's now like two broken glass
pile up.
Yeah, and they had to go and like clean it. We had to like keep everyone away. We're like, no going over here.
So I think needless to say that your night was much more interesting than both Fran and mine.
Yeah, well, like probably the weirdest part of the night was at one point Ethan pulled his shirt off because you can do that in a gay bar, and he was talking to some other muscular guy, and I go over to say goodbye to him because I have to go catch my bus. I'm like, hey, Ethan, see ya. And the other guy pulls off his shirt and then starts like rubbing Ethan's nipples. And I'm like,
oh, wow.
Oh, okay. Goodbye.
Very descriptive story.
Yeah. Goodbye. And then like I'm like walking away and I turn around just like to check he's okay. And the guy's like going to suck on his nipple. I'm like, okay, I gotta go.
Suck on his nipple?
Can you please clarify that?
To suck on his, like his face was
do
on
you
his chest.
Do you want to say nipple one more time? Nipple.
Nipple.
Okay. So anyway, now that we know how Halloween went for the three of us, there is another topic now. Hugh?
I'm also leading this one.
Oh, okay, okay.
So this
take,
one...
Take all the control, why don't you?
I fucking will. So, this one's a bit more news-focused. It's about Elon Musk. You guys,
Old Saint Elon.
I personally, I'm of the opinion, you know, eat the rich. So, that's...
Yeah, as you should.
Yeah. It's a fair opinion to have. So, this week, there was a CNN article that claimed that 2% of Elon Musk's wealth could solve world hunger, and it cited the UN World Food Program.
Okay.
Or the WFP. And so a guy named Dr. Eli David pointed out that 2% of his wealth is $6 billion. And the WFP raised $8.4 billion in 2020. That didn't solve world hunger. So he's like, why is this not a thing, you know?
Mm-hmm. So there's this expectation, is it, that Elon has to do this because it's been put out there?
Yeah. And so Elon responded and he said, if the WFP can, you know, like prove how the $6 billion would stop world hunger, I'll liquidate my
assets.
You'll
do it.
I'll donate the $6 billion. Then the WFP chief responded and he said, hey, this headline is inaccurate, but claims that the $6 billion could save 42 million people on the brink of starvation. And so there's kind of two questions that I kind of took out of this, which is, should Musk, as a private citizen and businessman, be obligated to donate his money to an organization that he's not related to nor responsible for? And I mean, personally, I have no problem saying that, no, not really under current law, you know, like there's no obligation nor financial incentive.
No, of course there isn't.
But should he, as a wealthy individual and human being...
So morals, we're kind of going into the second.
Yeah, it has to be morals.
What do you think?
I think I'm personally of the eat the rich as well. For me, I would definitely say I think he should contribute. But at the end of the day, it's like if they haven't had proof that this kind of money can use to solve world hunger, why would it solve it now?
Like it is a personal decision,
it
you
is,
know, but I don't think it's not really a good deed if you're going to guilt trip someone into it or have this expectation that someone has to do it because they can't.
But I mean, considering he's like, you know, going back and forth with Jeff Bezos being the richest man in the world.
Yeah,
I feel like if 2% of his wealth is $6 billion, you know, like more than I will ever have in my life.
More than anyone will ever see.
All of us combined.
Yeah, like that's... then
like
why
you could win the Euro Millions currently and you still wouldn't even be close.
You could win it like 10 times and you wouldn't be close. It's like he like, you know, there should be some sort of like feeling like he shouldn't be responding to like, hey, prove it and I'll do it. Like,
yeah.
Like,
but it is very Elon to kind of be like, hey, listen, if you prove it, I'll do it kind of thing.
Yeah.
You know?
And I feel like that's why the CNN article claimed that like 2% of Musk's wealth specifically, because at the end of the day, he's put himself in a position of being such a public figure that he's, you know, they're going to pick on him. So that's kind of that story. Any other opinions on that?
No, not necessarily. I'm not like huge into Elon Musk. What about you, Fran?
Not really.
No,
he's just there. I know more of him and his relationship with, what's her name?
Grimes.
Grimes, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't
that
know.
Grimes. Could walk down the street and I wouldn't know who she is.
Grimes is a musical artist who's also kind of this weird kind of faux anti-capitalist woman thingy.
Anti-capitalist, yet.
Yeah.
Anti-capitalist, yet. Who's she dating?
It's very funny. You heard the story about how they named their kid like X13 or something like that? Like...
Wait, did they actually?
Yeah, did you not hear about that?
No, dude, I'm old.
Oh, yeah.
I heard legally they had to actually change it.
D12. Oh, that's according to our producer. They named their child after a plane.
They named their child D. So is D the first name and 12 the second name? But our producer is just confirming that with us, because I don't know if you guys can hear it. So we're kind of just we're like channeling our producer in. Now, aside from our Halloween events,
yeah,
and aside from our lovely Saint Elon Musk, we also have something very interesting and very unique and very specific to where we're located, and that is DCU Confessions. So essentially, there is an Instagram page, if I'm not mistaken, here,
yeah,
and anyone or everyone can put up whatever they want. It's anonymous. So what we're going to do is, I think the best way to do it is, we could even like kind of pass the phone around if I want to start. So I'm going to like scroll through it and just stop at a random one and read it out. And then we're going to go to Hugh.
Yeah, sure. I've got a few funny ones lined up if you want to.
Oh, yeah, sure. Okay.
Yeah, okay. So there's the first one.
All there. Right. Here's the first one. So number 149. My roommate is a mad bitch and snapped our toilet seat whilst drunk. How do you.
That's.
Wait, what?
Apparently, this person's roommate is such a mad bitch that, is it she or well, we don't know. It's just this person they snapped the toilet seat while they were drunk. Did they like sit on it and lean and pull the toilet seat off?
Now, I've done that before.
Oh,
is the issue?
Oh, so you can relate? Are you sure?
Are you sure
that you're not the roommate?
I'm not the roommate. I can say with confidence I'm not the roommate. But I imagine it was probably that they twisted it off because you know.
They were twerking on the toilet seat while
no,
they were drunk.
Not twerk, torque.
Oh. When you're drunk, who knows what you're doing?
It probably helps get the shit out.
Now, there's kind of this one I feel like you'll relate to, Adam.
Me?
Yeah. This is number 142. It says, I took 1 year out. Now no one understands my references, any of my meme references. Why am I here?
So, kids, when you get older, this sad thing happens that you don't become funny anymore. But you're laughable, but just not funny. Why? I love the way you're specifically like, oh yeah, Adam, yeah, you're
like
relating to that
one.
Yeah,
you
like this one. All right, why don't we give Fran one of them?
Yeah,
Fran,
let's see. You
want
to just choose one?
Yeah, I will.
Well, we do, before Fran reads it out, we also do have two guests that are going to come on.
They're
so our producer will switch them on and they're going to read out one each. They look absolutely terrified looking at us, but nevertheless, it's going to be, oh, and I got a middle finger. See, there's no hiding from this. So
thank you very much, Amy.
Amy, which will read out her Instagram handle. No,
okay, guys,
I
found one. Okay. Confession number 164 said, to the ginger guy that I saw last Tuesday at the Astro, can I get on my knees for you?
Whoa, okay.
Oh,
also,
like
I think
prayer?
We should. Yeah, well, they could be Christian.
They could be.
It could be for prayer, you know? It could be they need to tie their shoelace.
Yeah.
Could
be just like, you know, just want to admire the shoes, admire what they're.
Maybe it was you.
Or if you're old as me, they could be fixing the Velcro on the shoes, not even the laces.
Maybe they wanted to custom paint the shoes.
Yeah, so that's exactly what happened. This person wants to get on their knees and paint it for this ginger person. So whoever you are, next time it happens, just make sure you bring your paintbrushes. Okay.
And also, make sure to tell the ginger guy that
you're Ed Sheeran.
Yeah.
All right. So now that us three have read one out, we're going to go on to our guests. So next is the wonderful Celine. So you pick one and read one out. Hi, how's it going? How are you?
Hi,
how are we doing?
Yeah, we probably should say hello.
Yeah, we should introduce you. Or do you want to introduce yourself?
I'm Celine. Study multimedia as well. That's about it.
Really?
What?
Really?
Yeah.
This is a reoccurring thing.
Fuck off.
I know, it's so strange. I've never seen you guys before in my lives.
Okay. So, do you want to read out any one of them?
I would, but I'm back on Hugh's Instagram page.
Oh, Hugh.
Yeah. So sexy in all those pictures. Thanks for the silence.
Don't worry. I agree. Don't worry.
Oh, thanks. Oh, thank you. Okay, just choose one.
Yeah, so we'll do these. We'll do these as quick as we can.
Oh, DCU Confessions 141. Where the hell are you guys finding all these people to fuck?
That's an interesting question.
That is an interesting question.
See, the context of that is there's just a lot of horny activity on that page.
Is there a site? Do you think DCU Confessions is an actual site, a bit like a Tinder?
Maybe. Do you think you can meet people on DCU Confessions?
Maybe.
Would you meet someone
conspiracy?
On these
Yeah, maybe that's how your one met the ginger one.
What do you think, Celine?
Are we uncovering the dark web right now?
We could be. God. Since you've arrived, it's all very sketchy stuff. What are you trying to tell
us, Celine? Are you DCU Confessions?
Are you the admin?
I'll just open up my trench coat and give you the passcode.
And just casually slips it across the table, F9. But that's that one. Thank you, Celine. So,
other guest, Amy, would you like to read out a DCU Confession?
Would you like to? Actually, why don't you see, because no one knows
well.
Amy. Amy, that's a very familiar name. Where have we heard this before?
Hi, I'm Amy. I'm the one who gave Adam the middle finger because I drive up with him every morning and he's very annoying.
Yeah, but I give you a lift, so be grateful.
And she quit the show because she hates us, I guess.
She hates us all individually.
Yeah,
a lot.
Like, I want you all dead.
Yeah, a lot.
You said that. Right, you now. Stopped her. You're like, I want you all. And I was like, oh, so is she part of DCU Confessions?
Anyways, I have this confession here, number 118, and it says, I got 5,000 in the Google dinosaur game during a lecture once. And that's very relatable to me, because I play Tetris.
AV is on Tetris, like, 24-7. Anytime I look at her during
that's
any of my
like,
lectures,
I sit beside
she's
her.
Just there like...
Fair enough, I watch videos, but like you can intensely hear her play and she gets so mad when she loses. And I'm just like, the game has to end at some stage. Now, for the old man in the room, what is the game?
Oh my god, well, how do you even explain Tetris? So then I was like,
Tetris
shame.
No,
game. The Google. Google.
Okay, so like when you go on Google Chrome, right, and if you don't have internet, there's like this little dinosaur jumping running game that just loads up when you don't have internet.
Oh
just,
yeah, Google
you have
randomly
to press
changes
space
there.
Bar. You press
so that's
space
that's
bar.
The new thing they have in it.
No, it's very old.
It is very old.
Yeah, a bit like yourself.
A bit like myself, grand. Okay, so now that we've all read one out, and we can keep our guests here if they'd like, but if not, it's up to them. So the next kind of category we're going to move on to, with our guest, our producer. So I might channel some stuff true from him or whatever, but we're going to do movies and TV. We're gonna be doing movies and TV and music. So Hugh or whoever, actually, do you know, Fran, you actually said that you were into... music. So why don't you kind of kick us off on that one?
Any music you've been hooked on lately?
Well, I'm always hooked on music all the time. For me personally, I'm really into like R&B genres. Oh. So like, I've been listening to a lot of Miguel. Don't know if anyone knows who Miguel is, but he's a really he's not old. Not like you, Adam. He's not old. Like
he's
you.
Not as old
you're
as
no,
me.
No, he's not. Okay. He's like 34. So you're like.
I've got 10 years
yeah,
on him.
Yeah, you have 10 years on him,
there
so
you go,
don't
ladies.
Worry about it.
Whole
yeah,
10 years.
But yeah, I listen to a lot of him. He's like a really established artist
in case,
as well.
In case you're, sorry, just to clarify, in case you're all hearing a noise of a door opening, that is our producer coming in to us. Oh, actually, never mind. I just realized that I'm hearing that from the studio, but you might hear him come into the room in a few seconds.
This is what happens when we're just starting.
This is episode two.
We don't know, but yeah, other than music, any shows or anything that anyone's been watching lately?
Well, I mentioned it earlier because I've actually been rewatching it with my dad. Hello, Mr. Producer. I'm rewatching Peaky Blinders with him because I think it's a pretty well-produced TV show by the BBC. A lot of the time when you're watching it, you kind of get this vibe that you're watching a movie more so than an actual TV series. And it is based around real events. You know, you've got like the outlooks of World War One and how it affected soldiers that came back. And as far as I'm aware, because I don't know if anyone else has watched it, the last season is like kicking off into World War II. You've got the Nazi party and fascism and everything coming into it. So it's really interesting. But I mean, we have to give a shout out to Cillian Murphy, you know, like bringing that Irish fame out there, plays a Birmingham guy quite well. You got
betrayal.
Another set of betrayal. Yeah, he went over to an English TV show. But aside from that, music wise, Amy introduced me to Keshi, which I'm quite proud of. Yeah. So why don't we move to Amy next, actually? Speak of the devil.
Hello.
Hello.
Just talking about shows, I rewatch shows a lot. Like, I've rewatched Brooklyn Nine-Nine, I don't even know how many times. But I'm currently rewatching The Umbrella Academy, which I love. Oh. If you guys haven't watched it, I really recommend it. It's really good.
Okay, and Jenna, why don't we go to our producer so you can finally hear the guy who's been talking absurdly into our ears and we're channeling him.
Yes, I'm very annoying.
This is
purpose.
Adolf.
I'm Adolf.
Adolf, our producer. His name sounds like Hitler's. and he acts like Hitler. So,
oh,
anything you
the best of both worlds.
I have the power to silence anyone if they do not have my views.
And you mute. Also burnt my books. So,
and he's fascist.
Anything, okay. Anything you've been watching?
Yeah. So, lots of good TV shows out there. Like, obviously, a very famous one being Game of Thrones.
Okay.
Then you guys watch Game of Thrones?
Boo.
Oh, yeah. Whoa. I'm going to get a lot of hate for that. Boo.
Why do you not like Game of Thrones?
Not the biggest fan of it. I tried to watch like the first like three or four episodes.
Why not?
I wasn't feeling it.
Okay.
It's not for everyone.
Well, if you don't like Game of Thrones because of like the dragons, that's a lot of things I hear. It's like, oh, I don't want to watch it because there's a lot of dragons. That's not realistic. You can always watch another TV show called Vikings.
Yes, Vikings is
my sister
show.
Was an extra on Vikings.
Oh, really?
Oh, well, she auditioned to be an extra. I don't
Very
think
nice.
She didn't get it. She didn't get it.
She auditioned to be an extra.
I think my
she's the axe holder.
I think my ex's aunt was like a set designer in that or something.
Oh. Yeah, it was aunt. Filmed up in Belfast.
Yeah.
So it's a local one, and they do a lot of auctions where you can buy pieces from it.
Oh, right.
Buy, like, artifacts from it.
Okay, okay. They did that with Game of Thrones as well,
they
didn't
they? But not very much of it. They, you know, they'd be very expensive for stuff like that. Another one. Is Drive to Survive, Formula One Drive to Survive, which is on Netflix.
What's it about?
It's about Formula One.
Oh, okay.
It's a TV show on Formula One, so if you didn't, if
Amy's
you're not
like shaking her head here, I don't think
Formula
she's into
One,
that.
You can watch it and know what happened all the way back to like 2017. But one that is might get people interested is there's a TV show on RTE Player, on RTE, called Kin.
Kin.
Kin. It's about Kin. The Kinahan and the Hutch gangs.
Whoa, okay. I didn't know about this.
I think that's what it is, but they changed the name. So as far as I'm aware, it's on the Kinahan and the Hutch. It has 8 episodes, and it's very, very good. It's set in Dublin, and it has Aidan Gillen from, he's in Peaky Blinders and Batman and stuff like that.
Oh.
You might have seen him.
Very good.
He's in it. Yeah, it's a very good TV show. I'm on the last episode, and
I'm
very good.
And any music recommendations? You seem to be an absolute geyser of info for movies, but do you have the same for music?
Well, just want one more TV
show. Oh, okay.
The Office. Just
oh,
watch The Office.
Okay, okay.
But not the English one. Not the English
Office,
one.
I mean,
yeah.
Do you know, you would be surprised the amount of people that know the memes from The Office, but
they
haven't actually
watched
The Office. Yeah.
Music.
I watch The Office.
Forced?
Well, forced is a strong word, but like everyone in my family loves it, so it's just always on, so that's how
it's
good.
Yeah, it's for music.
I mean, if we're still on TV shows, if we're not moving away from that for a second, I've been rewatching Atlanta recently, which is a really good show.
Atlanta.
Yeah, you've seen that? Yeah, it's produced by Donald Glover, who's like
Childish Gambino. Yeah. You didn't know.
Oh, Childish Gambino. Yeah.
Yeah.
You mean Donald Glover?
Yeah.
They're the same person.
Yes, they are.
It's like Dwayne Johnson and The Rock.
They are. They. Do you know they met
Dwayne
up for the
Johnson
first time?
Is my rock.
They met up for the first time there like a few weeks ago. Did you see that?
Okay. So how do we turn off his mic?
Yeah.
I have the power to do that.
Yeah. No. But I've been rewatching that lately. It's a really good show. Set in Atlanta, Georgia. It's about, you know, rap and drugs and sex. You know, all the fun stuff in life.
Yeah.
No. It is a very good show. It's a good drama and mixed with the comedy.
Also,
if
just
we're
to
on
let you
TV
know,
shows as well.
Our producer's leaving, so in case you hear.
Hi guys.
And then there goes our producer.
If we're talking still about TV shows, I have one more.
We can all talk shit about him now. He's gone quick.
I watch Glee. Like, well, not the first time. I've rewatched that show like maybe 50,000 times. A bit too much, but yeah, I absolutely love it. Like, I know everyone hates it. It's like a niche thing, but.
I've heard like a lot of good things about it, like
and a lot of bad things, which are also true. Yeah, it's not a great show, but it's a great show.
It's a good show to like watch with your brain off. Like,
yeah. Like, don't take it absolutely. Do not take that show seriously, or else you will like die.
Twitter loves that show. Though.
Yeah, exactly.
Celine, anything else? Any input from you?
I'm not really watching anything at the minute.
Are you sure? Last time I talked to you, you said you were watching Netflix.
Okay. Well.
I
you just
have
sit,
something
you
about
just
the
sit
term watching Netflix like, just never made sense to me. It's like, I'm watching Netflix. Like,
do you chill while you're watching Netflix?
Of course I do.
You see Netflix, you chill?
See, like, I just finished 2 shows and now I'm just sitting there and I'm like, I have nothing to do with my life.
Okay, well, now you've received about like 500,000 recommendations, even though it's not even close to 500,000. I can't count. You've much more to watch.
Yeah, so many episodes now. I mean, Game of Thrones will take me about like 2 months to get through, so.
Yeah, just don't bother. I'd say is probably the best thing to do.
I agree.
Amy, did you have your hand up there?
Sorry, I was just going to bring it back to Donald Glover. I recommend Community.
Oh, of course. I really recommend Community.
I love it. Like, not a lot of people know about it, but it's on Netflix now, so it's, like, gotten popular again since being on Netflix, so I really recommend it.
It's a cult classic that shows.
So now that we've all kind of given recommendations on movies and music and X, Y, and Z, so you, the listeners, can check it out and let us know what you think. Feel free to comment down underneath the video or send us a response about what you think about your favorite shows, etc., music. We're going to do a segment that we did last week called Fact or Cap. So basically, Hugh, you got to explain this one. How does it work?
So everyone in the booth will be presented with a question, and you get two options, fact or cap. It's easy as fact, it's true. Cap, it's false. Amy is laughing at it.
Amy, for some reason, finds this hilarious.
I was put on the spot. Adam, I wasn't expecting to do this to me.
You're very welcome. So I'm going to ask one or two, and then we can move on to each other. So we do have this beautiful music queued up by our producer. I don't know if our producer is listening to us. But and we'll play it over so you guys can hear it. So we've got this lovely suspenseful music. No one's ever heard of it. It's from a very small show.
Niche.
You know,
in fact, very niche. We made it up.
We made it. Yeah, it's such a niche market these days. So I'm going to ask the first question. All right, here we go. So, fact or cap, the Statue of Liberty was a gift from France.
I say fact.
I also say fact.
Fact.
I also say fact.
All right. Drum roll, please. It's a fact. Yay! The French actually gave it to America America, specifically New York, as a gift from them. There is a sketch from it in, I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's The Simpsons or Family Guy or something, but the Statue of Liberty. Oh, no, I think it's Big Mouth. And the Statue of Liberty actually comes to life, and she's like a French woman, and she's talking to one of the female characters, and she's all like, you know, oh yeah, like I'm French and whatever. And I was like, oh, so the Statue of Liberty was originally from France, but there you go. All right, so that's my question. We'll go clockwise, so we'll move to...
I feel like you should give us a personal question about yourself.
Oh, a personal question. Okay. Yeah. All right, so one that we're not
that
really
was just
gonna...
to get the gist of the game.
Yeah, so now you guys understand. That was exactly what it is. I definitely wasn't taking that seriously. So we're going to roll the music again. It's going to be a fact or cap question personally about us. You probably said this when you were introducing it, and I didn't hear it.
Yeah,
it's at my old man ears. Yeah, my hearing aids off.
Old man.
My geriatric ears.
His hearing is at like 50% now.
And like the dementia as well just isn't helping.
Everything's
anything.
Kicking in. You know, it's all downhill from here, kids. So, fact or cap about me. Here we go.
And we wait for the music.
We cue the music. All right. So I'm being put on the spot because I did not actually prepare this. So fact or cap about me. Okay. One that we've talked about. Not in full depth, but did I set up my custom shoe page 3 years ago? Fact or cap?
I'm gonna say
without looking at your phones.
I'm gonna say fact.
I'm gonna say cap.
I'll go fact.
Oh, cap.
All right, drum roll. It's cap. We got two winners and two losers. Fuck. I set it up 2 years ago.
2 years ago, yeah. Okay.
It was just before the pandemic, so 2019.
Okay, that's very nice.
Okay, Hugh, do you have any fact or cap?
I got one prepared.
Unlike me.
Well, I've just been thinking of them for the past 5 minutes because I realized I did not prepare a fact or cap.
You're just backtracking horribly in your mind.
I'm like, it's a shitty one. You'll get it. But I mean, we'll be more prepared for next time. It's some growing pains. So we got the music. Okay, so as everyone can see, I got this jacket here. Very nice jacket. Did I spend 150 euro on this jacket? Fact or cap?
All right, we're going to go clockwise, Fran.
Fact.
Oh my god.
I'll go cap.
I'm going to say cap because I know how much you spent on your shoes, so I don't know if it'd be the same on your jacket.
Okay, drum roll. It's cap.
Yes.
Yay.
I spent 200 euro on this jacket.
Oh, okay. So we were still wrong. Our producer looked shocked when he heard that.
It's a merch jacket for an album. I'm not happy about it. I waited 7 months for it, but I have it.
What album is it from?
Roadrunner by Brockhampton. I'll talk about it next.
Brockhampton, nice.
I love Brockhampton.
We'll talk about
why didn't we talk about Brockhampton?
Why we literally we had not? Like.
We all know. Okay, we're talking about that next week. All
right, Fran. Right, Fran, we're going to move on to you.
Okay. Cue the music. Come on.
We're just waiting for.
Okay, fact or cap? I have fractured my pinky 3 times.
I'll go fact.
I'll go cap.
I'm gonna say fact.
I'm gonna have to go with cap here. I don't think it's that many.
I think it'd be more.
All right, drum roll. drum roll, everyone.
Okay, drum roll. It is a fact.
Hey.
How?
Sports.
Oh, fair enough.
What sports do you play?
I play basketball. Football, Gaelic.
Was that the 3 times you injured it? Each?
No, twice was for basketball and once was for Gaelic.
You should have just done it with each sport to like mark it.
our
producer's just like dunking it in there. So there you go. He's representing good old basketball. So anyway, Celine, it's your turn.
Ooh, are we doing personal ones?
Yeah,
or?
Yeah, personal. It doesn't have to be too personal.
Okay. When I was younger, my dream car to drive was a tank.
Okay.
Fact.
I'm gonna say fact as well.
That's gonna be a fact for me.
I'm gonna go the opposite. I'm gonna say cap.
It is fact.
Yeah. Yay. You are not on a good streak
today.
I'm not,
literally.
What child wouldn't want to drive a tank?
Yeah. I said this to my friend another day, and I was like, would you not want to drive a tank?
And she looked
at me like I was the stupidest person in the world. She was like, why would I want to drive a tank?
Maybe she wants to push a tank.
No. She was like, what is a tank? And I was like, listen, that's
what
a separate conversation for a different day.
They should have thrown her on the front lines and just been like, here's a tank. And now you're getting blasted.
Good luck.
Your friend is probably a lovely person, by the way. So shout out to your
friend. We love you.
All right, shout out to that friend.
Finally, we move to the one and only.
Me.
The micro assassin, Amy.
Oh my god, okay, I kind of have to think about this. Okay, I have something.
So
okay.
To translate, she said, I kind of have to think about this.
Okay, so factor cap, I used to sleep in all of my geography classes in secondary school.
Oh, that's easy. I'm gonna say that's fact.
Yeah, fact. Fact.
Okay, I picked one too.
There we go, is it?
Hey. Back.
Yay!
Okay. Who didn't sleep in geography? Let's be honest with you.
I slept in history.
Like, yeah, oh no,
bro,
history.
History's important.
No, but I had such a shitty teacher. Like, I love this subject, but my teacher was so shitty. She had like the thickest Donegal accent that would drill through your head. And so I'd be in the back and I'd get nice and cozy and I just.
You just drift off. My teacher was the opposite. She was this. So for all the fellas out there, you know, keep calm. She was a really short, ginger haired, really, really nice legs teacher. And she was so passionate. She just used to walk around and look at you and be like, Bismarck and Wilhelm. And I used to look back at her and be like, yeah, keep telling me that. keep talking about Bismarck. No, but she was actually a really, really good teacher. Why did none of us like geography? Just off the side.
No, I loved geography.
Oh, I was good at it, so I feel like I had to like it because I was naturally good at it, but I wasn't.
There's something up with people who like geography.
No, yeah. It was our teacher, though. She was the nicest person who existed in the school. So, like, at the end of the year, we all got together and we bought her a bit of, like, rainforest to, like, preserve it.
Oh, you bought her. Yeah. You bought her a rainforest.
We sponsored preservation of the Amazon. Oh. And that was her gift. And she was also pregnant at the end of it. So she like left, she came back.
Oh, wow.
And she just started crying. We were like, oh my God, this is such a sad day.
I feel like people that like geography also like driving tanks as kids.
Yeah. It just goes hand in hand. It does.
My history teacher one time called me Hitler.
No,
but that's our producer.
No, genuinely, one time I fell asleep in her class and she woke me up and she goes, Hugh, you're Hitler. And I went, huh? What?
pulls out a Luger. It's like, finally, my time has come.
I was very confused. The context was she wanted me to role play as Hitler for something to do with the Winter War.
She wanted you to role play.
What was she on? Look, trust me, I hate this teacher with all my guts. I can't even imagine it like that.
It's just hate role play.
Okay, look.
Okay.
Adam, you're getting a bit too out of pocket. We're going to have to put you back in your...
Yeah, I need to
your,
take my medicine.
We're going to have to put you back in the hospital. The old people home.
No, in the
middle-aged hospital. I haven't hit there yet. I'm not that old.
So listen...
Before we wrap it up, does anyone have anything else they would like to talk about or like to say to our guests? Do you want to promote anything while you're on here? In case you're not on next time. Okay.
No.
Okay, well, we got a head shake. We got a head shake and we got a no. So I think we're going to wrap it up here, guys.
So just thank you for listening. And this has been Fran.
And Hugh.
And Adam.
And this has been the Tequila Cap Show. And remember,
Stop the Cap. Do you know how it feels to be left outside alone? When it's going on.
Okay,
and that's it. Thank
Let's
you.
Let's go to fucking class. Did it.